Okay, what's going on, guys? We just got back from the beach, and so I got these nice fish that I'm gonna clean up. So first, we got this goatfish right here, about 9 or 10 inches, I believe. And then we have this this nice Omilu, and then we got the Nenue, or chub, as some people call them. So I unfortunately didn't get catching them on camera, but I went back out there and I did a little bit of filming, and I caught a couple other fish and stuff, and so I can play those clips right now. That kind of gives you like the general idea of pretty much how we caught these fish. They're a ton of fun to catch because, you know, I was using super light, lightweight line, light rod, and yeah, they're just a ton of fun. So I'm gonna show you guys how I fillet them and skin them and how I'm gonna cook them. So stay tuned. Okay, so the first fish I'm going to fillet is this this nice Omilu right here. The first thing I want to do is I want to find where the head meat ends. It's like right in there. I'm gonna take my knife and I'm gonna run it up here, right by this fin, and run it all the way down there into that head meat. Right about there. Then I'm going to cut down through the skin all the way to the back of the fish. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna kinda slice down this backbone, try and get as much meat as I can. Run as close to these bones as I can get, because I don't wanna waste any of this fish. Right down there, that's right over the spine. Cut through those pin bones, down through here. Now, once I get to about there, I'll cut around this gill plate right here. Cut all the way up to that top head meat cut. I'll slice all the way down here to the stomach, which I already gutted, but I didn't get that on camera because I don't really feel like getting demonetized. I'm just gonna get all that meat over the ribcage right there. Pop my knife through there. And cut all the way along. Then just try and pick up the rest of this meat over here. So I'm gonna cut down here. Just cut off this, this part of the belly. Nice white meat. Doesn't look like there's too much of a bloodline. I'll just go through. There we go, there's the first fillet. But it's not done yet. So there's a set of pin bones right down here through the middle.
all I'll do is just cut right along there like that. There we go. And I should be able to just pull them right out like that. There we go, we got most of the pin bones out of there. A lot of people like to pull the skin off. I prefer to cut it. It's just easier for me. I like to get a little bit like that. Pull down just slightly so you can get your knife under there. There we go. That's a boneless, skinless piece of fish right there. It's perfect. That's going on the grill. And we're just gonna do to the same to this bottom part right there, and then the other side. But same thing here, you just start up right against this, fins. And we'll just pop through down there, slice along, and then work this this back right here. There we go, just work down back right there, all the way down to the spine, and what you hear right now, like that, those are the pin bones, which are the tiny little bones by the spine, which we'll end up cutting out anyway, so. It's not that big of a deal. Just cut around here. So we just got done with that first side, and then just like the last one, just gonna cut out the pin bones and then skin it and do the same on the other side. Okay, so we just got this one last fish, and this is this nice goatfish that I caught the other day, and yeah, I'm super excited to eat this. This is one of our favorites, so here we go. Right up here by the head. I don't want to waste any meat because it's not very big. Okay, so my knife was getting a little dull there, so I just sharpened it real quick. And then now I'm just gonna get back to filleting this fish. Make a cut right up here. Just like the other fish, just kind of go along the backbone like that. Just trying to get as much meat as I can. Just cut along the bottom like that. Cut through the ribs, or I can cut along that. So yeah, I'm just gonna finish up filleting this fish, do the same on this side as the other side, and yeah, I'll get back to you when I'm ready to start cooking. So these right here are all the ingredients we're going to use for grilling the fish. We're pretty much just gonna do it like last time I did one of these things. I'm going to lay down some tin foil, put in the fish, add butter, garlic salt or salt, pepper, Ms. Dash's lemon and pepper, and some lemon. So, yeah. So, I think the first one we're going to do is going to be... which one should I do first? Or no, the first one I'm going to do is the Nenue. So, all I'm going to do is just lay it down in here. I don't want to over-season it, but I do want to, you know, because I want to get the flavor of the fish in there. Okay, so I think instead of grilling this fish, we're going to end up smoking it. So instead of completely covering it up like I'm going to do with some of the other fish, I'm just going to make pretty much like a little dish out of it. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to season it up a little bit. Just sprinkle on a little bit of the Mrs. Dash's lemon pepper. Put that on there. Good. And then I'm going to cut up the lemon and the butter. We'll grab it. Okay, so now I'm just gonna, like I said, we're just gonna cut up that lemon. Slice it pretty thin. And then we're going to just cut up some of the butter real quick. There we go. Put it around the fish. Should be good. And then we're just going to add some of that lemon. And then it's going straight on the smoker. That should be good. Now, let's go put it out on the smoker. Okay, so I'm gonna try and do this as quick as I can because I don't want to let out too much of the heat. Then I'm just gonna take off the lid and throw in the fish. Just like the last one, I just have a piece of tin foil, except that this one's gonna go on the grill. So this is goatfish right here, boneless, skinless. So we're just going to lightly season that, and then put on some butter and lemon, just like the last one, and some of the Mrs. Dash's lemon and pepper. And then I'll just sprinkle a little bit of salt. Now I'll put on some butter. Just like the last one. Then I'll add a little bit of lemon. That should be good. We're just gonna wrap this up and throw it on the grill. So we're just going to cook up half of the papillo on the grill and then throw half of it in the pan. And so just like the other fish, I'm just going to season it up with some butter, some lemon, and then salt and pepper and stuff. Perfect. So we're just going to wrap this up and throw it on the grill for goatfish. Gonna throw them on here next to the antelope sausages. Maybe just wait a couple minutes and they should be done. So I lightly seasoned the rest of the papillo. Then I'm just gonna go straight into this egg wash which I add a little bit of lemon juice to. It just gives a little bit more flavor, and then I am gonna add it to this panko, which I also lightly season. I'm just gonna roll that around in the panko. And I'm gonna get the second piece right here. Get the egg wash. Now the oil is nice and hot, so I'm gonna, just going to put it right on in. Alright, let's see. Yeah, I'll turn it down a little bit. There we go. And the second piece too. Flipped these over a minute ago, and yeah, we're just gonna cook them until they're brown on each side and white and flaky all the way through. Okay, so the fish is about done. It's nice and brown on each side. So we're just gonna take it off and put it onto the paper towel. So this is the final product, and it all looks and tastes really good. It's all super white and flaky, and yeah, it's just really good. If you like this video and you want to see more of this sort of thing, please like it and tell me in the comment section below. And yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time.